everyone, if f of 3 equals 4, f prime of 3 equals negative 6, g of 3 equals 2, and g prime of 3 equals 5, we're going to find the following. Notice we're evaluating all at 3 here with different values. So we use different things. The first one, we're using the addition property. So basically, we're just going to do f plus g prime f3, we're doing this first problem, equals f prime of 3 plus f prime of g of 3. I'm sorry, this is g prime of 3. Can't think straight. All right, so basically, we're just going to write this as f prime of 3 is negative 6 plus g prime of 3 is 5. So that's going to equal negative 1. So it's easy enough on that. Now on the multiplication one, we have to use our product rule. So we're just going to take our f and write, so let's write this fg prime of 3. So that's going to be f of 3 times g prime of 3 plus g prime of 3, or g of 3 times f prime of 3. That's using the product rule. When you fill everything in, you're going to get 4 times 5 plus 2 times negative 6. So this is going to be 20 minus 12 equals 8. And that's your final answer. Now for the last one, we're using the quotient rule. So we use that. And always this one, you have to be more careful with what you start for with. So f3. So you have to start with g first, and you're going to write g of 3 times f prime of 3 minus f of 3 times g prime of 3, all divided by g of 3 squared. Now, we just substitute. So just substitute all these four numbers in. You're going to get 2 times negative 6 minus 4 times 5 divided by 2 squared. And this is going to give you negative 32 divided by 4, which equals negative 8. And that's your final answer. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.